Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Study Free Exams. So friends, here we are talking about an important thing regarding AFCAT. So we have the exam 20 and 21st Feb. Okay, only few 3 to 4 days left for some 3 and for some 4, right? So you have to know how to attempt the exam and how to manage your time, right? So managing the time in exam makes you free and comfort. When your mind is comfort, what will happen? You will get the answers easily. And if you are panic, you will lose your memory and your mind will not work. For knowing questions also, you will make wrong attempts of answers, right? So if you have so much of time, you can freely without nervousness and you can successfully complete the exam and you will clear the exam easily. So for that, I will tell you here some tips how to select the topic. So here we'll talk this only. Okay, so if you see what is the cutoff mark is, you have know that is 150 to 160 marks only. This is the only area where the highest cutoff is there up to now. Well, less than 160 only, 160 is also not there cutoff. So for 160, your target must be to attempt two short questions of 55 only, right? 55 is also more enough, right? So you have to two shortly 55 questions attempts, right? So how many questions we have in this exam? We have only 100 questions, in out of which we have 4 topics, right? What are they? English, right? Next, general awareness and reasoning and arithmetic, right? These 4 topics are there, and in these 4 topics, English covers 25 questions, general awareness 25, reasoning 32, arithmetic 18. These are the question numbers in which we have to short questions 55 for clearing the cutoff, right? So for clearing the cutoff, and this total for 100 questions will have how much time? 120 minutes, that is 2 hours. More than 1 minute we are getting for questions. But there are so many questions in the AFCAT exam, time taking questions. For example, arithmetic, it will take more and more time. English also takes some time, right? But reasoning and general awareness, these are not time taking questions. So you must prefer reasoning or general awareness for first. But out of these 2, which one you have to take? You have to take general awareness? No. Why general? No, you have to not take general awareness. General awareness questions, syllabus is very fast. You must not cover all the syllabus. That is luck based questions are there. If luckily you will get some questions which you have read of sometimes there are the questions which you have even know what is the meaning. Like some capitals they will ask, the country name you never listen also, that will be options, right? So if you know these questions, right, if you didn't know the questions, you can't do anything in general awareness. But these questions are 25 number. If you just attempt 5 short short questions out of 25, then what will happen to your moral, right? When first starting 25 questions, you are just attempting 5 questions and it will take time 15 minutes. So you will get panic. So to avoid this panic, you have to first attempt reasoning. First attempt must be reasoning. Why? Because out of these 32 questions, how many questions you can attempt easily? You can attempt easily 25 questions for an average student. See, right? So out of 32, if you are attempting 25 questions, it is it makes you boost, right? Okay, out of 32 questions, I had attempted 25 questions. So your mind will actively and you will not become nervous, right? So first attempt must be reasoning, right? This is I'm just sharing my view only. I am not compelling you to first select the writing reasoning only. That is your own choice. If you want to follow, you can follow this one, right? Reasoning makes you 32 questions. So out of these 30 questions, you have to get choose out 25 minimum. Somebody more less than 25, but 20 is minimum, 20 to 25. But you have to get for clearing with good preparation, you get 25 easily. Next topic is general awareness you have to set. Why? Because out of these 25 questions, you may get or you may not get. But these 32 questions will take you 40 minutes, right? These 40 minutes, approx 40 to 45 minutes. If you take 45 minutes also, no problem, but you are attempting more questions, right? So these 25 questions will take less than 15 minutes only. Not 15 minutes, I am taking 15 minutes, but less than 15 minutes only you will complete this 25 minutes. Why? Because you know answer, that means you had clear, you will tick the answer. You didn't know answer, you didn't tick, right? Why? Because we have negative marking here. Here, so in these 25 questions, at least 10 questions you can easily attempt if you have prepared well, right? So 10 questions, that means we are clearing 35 questions here. 35 questions in how much time? 60 minutes. This is maximum. You can complete it in 45 to 15 minutes only. But I am telling 60 minutes. So out of this 60 minutes, we have completed 57 questions. Right, we have left with two topics and we have more than 43 questions only, right? In these 43 questions, English is 25, okay, English is for 25 and arithmetic is for 18. This arithmetic is time taking, right? So you will not take this arithmetic, so we have to go for English. English also only paragraph and some paragraph only will take time to read. Otherwise, all the questions also you have to just, if you know the question answer, you have to tick, otherwise you can't tick, right? So it will also take maximum 20 minutes only, right? So the 60 minutes and 20 minutes, it will cover 80 minutes. We have left with 40 minutes. In 40 minutes, we have to complete 18 questions only. This means your mind will actually, so I have 40 minutes of time and your mind will now, without any tension, without any panic, you will now come to arithmetic, right? In arithmetic, what will happen? In 18 questions, if you feel freely and do, there are so many easy questions, 5 easy questions, general questions. If you just read the question 1 to 2 times, you can easily clear the 5 questions if you didn't know maths also. That is practical questions they will ask. And with some preparation, you will attempt more than 5, right? So totally you will attempt 12 to 13 questions easily. But if you have time, take only 10 questions. Now already in English we have attempt 10 questions here, right? So short short questions are now in reasoning 25, English 10, GA 10, general awareness 10 and English 10. So we are getting 55 questions, which is easily clear or cut off. So after that, these 55 questions, you have, when you are going through all the paper, you have some come across some questions which you have only, you are confusing in two options. 50 questions are there. If you want to attempt, you want, then you can attempt that questions. But if when you are attempting 10 questions, that must be, you must be sure that out of 10 questions I will compulsory 5 or compulsory 4, so that these 55 questions will not affect with your negative marking, right? So why? Because this is the minimum cutoff you have to clear. So if it is positive, if you are that 50-50, if you will get marks, it is good, it will increase your score. Otherwise, if you can't, don't go for taking the answers without blindly, don't tick, right? Why? Because negative marking is there. Many of the people will do this mistake and just click all the questions. Don't go. Only hard target is 65 questions is our, including all the guest questions also, not more than this, right? So this makes you time manager, better time management. So topics must be, first one is reasoning, next one is general awareness, next one is English. In last, you have to go for arithmetic, right? In this process, if you attempt the FCAT exam, it makes you very comfortable and there are a lot of chances to clear the written exam, right? So if you like this video, please like, but please click on the like button. If you want to share this video, you can please share to the friends who are preparing for FCAT. If you have any doubt regarding FCAT, you just comment on the comment box. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.